The Agile Manifesto is celebrating its coming of age. That's right, that manifesto with the four values and 12 principles is turning 21 years old this year. As you know me, I love bringing things back to basics. Anything related to Agile, I like to strip them off of frameworks. So I figured, why not celebrate by bringing every month one of each of the 12 Agile principles from the manifesto and have a quick chat. So let's start with the first one. Our highest priority is to satisfy the customer through early and continuous delivery of valuable software. So let's dissect it real quick. The priority is the customer, in case people are confused on what should be a priority on how to do things. Well, you gather that sort of information on what your customer sees as a priority. And the manifesto is actually very specific on the how to satisfy the customer. And that how is through value, what the customer wants and needs. Not through those, sure, you could have great ideas for your product, you and your team, but that's not how really you go about and prioritize things. That's how things used to be mostly in the 90s and earlier, especially in the software industry. And honestly, at that time, you would hear a lot of customers saying that certain products were clunky or they didn't like such and such feature. And that's because there was a lot of unilateral decision making in those companies. Hey, I have an idea, I'll make it this way. Now you take it and use it. Now, what happened today is that through things like Agile, you can reach viral stages of adoption for your product. And this is really what is more aligned with design thinking, human-centered design, and similar technologies for product creation and development. So is this all about what the customer wants then, all the time? For the most part, yes, they use it. They buy it. So it's really best for you and for your business to at least think like the customer or use any technology to really capture what the customer really wants and needs. Now, I know there is a caveat in there. There are certain things that are for the product that your customer might not want or even think about sometimes. It's too behind the scenes for them. And it's going to range from things like great quality, performance, high levels of security, legal and compliance. That's true. The customer doesn't need to know these things, and many times they don't, but you have to be attuned to that. And it's still related to bringing value to your customer. So we satisfy the customer. We do so by bringing about value. And the thing is that this value, what the customer wants, what the customer needs, is delivered early and often. Continuous delivery. And continuous delivery is a non-issue today. Honestly, the technology is on our side for many, many years now. If you're talking about software products, 10, 15 years ago, this started being solved. So really, when we talk about continuous delivery, the issue at hand is usually not about technology and infrastructure. It is about mindset. It is about really understanding and accepting that value is only realized when the product is out there. If you have a feature, if you have a prototype, it's still in the making. It's not in the hands of the customer yet. So at this point, it's irrelevant. It really isn't relevant. It's just as ethereal as an idea. Value will be clear once it's out there, in the hand of the customer, with the market, so that they can give feedback. And feedback will be either, yay, it works, and then it ranges in levels of success that you can obtain, or you will learn. And learning is such a key piece of working in Agile. That will be it for today. So there is a link down below in the description in which you can go and check out the blog in which I expand the conversation a little bit more, and leave a question or a comment if you have any, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.